We're on.
And we're on.
Score. Okay.
Hi. Welcome back to Come Knit With Us, episode 38.
Yay.
I did good. You didn't even tell me I had to do it.
I didn't even have to tell you.
I didn't have to tell you. So, who are you?
Oh, hi. I'm Kim. I'm also known as Kimmy Knits.
Everywhere.
K-I-M-I-K-N-I-T-S.
Kimmy Knits.
Kimmy Knits. Oh, that's right. I'm doing Kimmy Knits for Dan.
Wait, oh. For Dan.
I'm Kimmy Knits on Ravelry, Instagram, and Twitter, and Kimberly Jones on YouTube.
And just wonderful.
Who are you?
Hi. How are you?
Goofball.
I go by Sam. My name is Samara. I am Kermit Von Frog 12 on YouTube and on Ravelry, and I'm Kermit Von Frog on Twitter and Instagram.
Okay, you're Kermit Von Frog.
12. Did I not say 12?
You didn't say 12. I don't think you said 12. Fudge.
Fudge. That's what I said.
Did you just fudge? Because
no,
I heard...
I said fudge.
Okay. Think of her fudge. You know what we should do? You should put Kermit Von Frog 12 and then you should put Kimmy Knits underneath.
No. This is my whiteboard. This is what I... My...
It's also an advertisement for your Twitter.
This is me here on YouTube.
Ravelry and YouTube. Okay.
And then this is...
Oh my god! That is so not right.
I love you.
That is so not right. No, you don't.
So anywho, she even has to correct me on my own name.
I was just trying to help you, and then you were mean to me.
St. Candy's gonna get mad.
I know, St. Candy. My St. Candy.
Nope.
Wrong side?
Mm-hmm.
Navi did not help
no,
me.
No, pocket
said,
watch.
It's, pocket watch, yeah, yeah, whatever.
There you go.
Okay, St. Candy.
Yeah.
She's gonna get you.
Me?
She's gonna get you.
I'm her favorite.
You were mean to me.
She probably enjoyed it.
I did not.
You did too.
I wasn't saying
you did. I said my mother probably enjoyed it.
My mother might have.
Sippy sippy. True.
Sippy?
Yeah.
And
her favorite color combination is teal. Go, Bonnie. It's your birthday. Go, Bonnie. Did you see her come shopping with me at Target?
Yes.
Earthworm
when she
mode
does
is my
the
thing.
Earthworm, when she walks into a store and she puts the camera way low, it is so
We're
funny.
Talking about graveyard girl, Bunny, and she just makes us giggle. That's all. She just makes us giggle. Hey, so, what are we doing first?
Well, first I thought I would ask you about your week. We do have specific segments today.
Okay.
We have Showgirls for Show and Tell. We have
It's Alive!
It's Alive!
For Finished Objects. We have...
Or with the Palooza Extravaganza-thon.
That's right. We have Hoarder's Corner for Stash Enhancement.
Uh-huh.
And I think that's...
What's on our needles?
That's Showgirls.
Is Show that Showgirls?
And Tell.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Never mind. I have no idea.
Yeah. Show and Tell is what we've got going on now.
Yeah. Okay. I'm corrected.
We're trying really hard to sort out this new format, and some
it's
of us
fun.
Are having a more difficult time with it than others. Yes, what do I?
There's a whiteboard in my face.
That's right.
I did have an interesting week, though.
Okay, so tell me about your week. While we knit, because people like to see us knitting
I know.
While we're doing this.
My AC went out again.
Again.
Ugh. So 3 days of hellacious heat, but it's
sticky
back on,
hotness.
So I'm much better now.
I'm so glad.
But other than that, my week was just fine.
It was very traumatic when you lost your air.
Again.
Yeah.
That's okay, though. It's all back.
I was very sad.
How was your week?
My week was meh, like it usually is.
You lost power once.
It was work. My power went out the same night. It was Tuesday night, because it was the night before we had to all go back to work and school and stuff.
Uh-huh.
So yeah, it was Tuesday night. We lost power for like 3 hours at 10:30.
Did you feel
it's
that?
Almost one. No.
This ghostly icy air just breezed up on me. I'm like, where'd that come from?
You're getting ghostly icy air?
It was nice. It's very refreshing.
I'm getting nothing but hot.
Oh, it's because you're sitting next to me. It's getting hot in here.
Oh my god. Really? Really?
Yeah.
Really? Squirrel! change the subject. Have you met Squirrel? Squirrel is here so that he can tell you when this one completely goes off track.
I feel like we're doing a Captain Kangaroo program right now.
We are. He was one of my favorites.
It's Green Jeans.
That's right.
That's right.
And Moose. And Rabbit. Mr. Rabbit.
And all the ping pongs.
All the ping pong balls. So, that was my week.
Well, our week, I watched Helen. Did I watch Nick? Nick Necaroni. Did she want to do this one? No. Blake did one. Right? Who did a podcast this week that we watched?
Isn't that terrible? I watched Don and James on Wolf Farms.
Yes.
On Monday.
Yes.
I watched...
Then how did you not see James's sock?
I told you I must have gotten up and like
did
changed the dog's
important.
Water or something. Or
yeah, because I think he did something. That in the S'mores colorway from Desert Vista Dye Works.
Yeah.
Which was lovely. Fight Ooh. Like a girl, Fuji. Fight like a girl.
Fight like a girl. We have to tell the story.
Okay. You tell her. She's such a good storyteller.
I am not. But we have to share with you that after last week's episode, and I would show it on my phone, but I know it's not going to show up in the camera.
Yeah.
But after we recorded last week's episode, at the end of the episode, if you will remember, we were joking about... Desert Vista Dye Works, Susan
Hayes,
was, because we follow her on Instagram because we be fangirls big time. So we noticed on her Instagram that she had gone to IKEA, which is like, right, not that far away. I won't say right down the street, but it's not far.
It's closer to us here at Tempe Yarn and Fiber than her house.
Well, yeah, but that wasn't the whole reason. Mesa is also very close to Tempe, so we kind of figured, joking... I
know I did.
I did too.
I said, "Why don't you come see us?"
Yeah, on her picture that, oh my gosh, you're so close. You should come by Tempe Yarn and Fiber and see us. Not thinking in a million years that she would.
We didn't think she would.
Because she don't know us. We just random people that just respond to her Instagram pictures. And so we were joking at the end of our episode about how funny that would be, but there was no way in the world that she was ever going to do it. But that was okay because I had yarn from her that I was going to, you know, use, and it was going to be very exciting and I would be happy.
But then after we were done recording, we checked her Instagram feed.
After we finished, I looked at my Instagram and there was a reply from Susan saying with 3:30 or 4 o'clock work, she was having lunch.
We're like, yeah. She totally came out and hang out with us.
Oh, my God.
It was so cool.
We met her.
She's very nice.
We met her.
She's very real.
She came here.
She did come
with
here.
With her husband and her son.
And daughter.
Her daughter. Her daughter, Savannah. Oh, my God, I'm so sorry, Savannah.
Don't embarrass her. She's having volleyball.
I'm sorry. I've got son on the brain. Sorry, we have boys.
Yeah,
I never think
boys.
Daughter. Susan and her husband and her daughter.
Mm-hmm.
Showed up at Tempe Yarn and Fiber. Oh
and
my God.
And hung out with us.
Oh my God, she did.
Well, and we even took selfies with her.
Very excited. We did take selfies. And
she
if you
took
guys,
a selfie too, and
she
posted
did.
It.
She did. If you guys follow us on Instagram or Twitter, you will have seen that picture. But yes, we met her. It was very exciting.
We got to talk about some cool stuff.
Yeah,
too.
But we can't say.
Well, she's already announced what she told us about it.
Well, part of it, yeah,
not the other
she
part.
Did.
No, not the other
but
part.
But we can't, we're keeping it secret.
No.
We're keeping it
no.
secret. But yeah, it was so exciting. And she does have a 3-year anniversary event going on right now. So go to her Ravelry group,
uh-huh.
Desert Vista Dye Works, and check it out. Or follow her on Instagram, at Desert Vista Dye Works.
Uh-huh.
And she's got a contest and some prizes
yeah.
that you can win. So go check it out. It's really exciting.
It's awesome.
It is.
She has amazing things.
So yeah, that was our excitement for the
that
week.
That was our so
What's
much
our timer look like? Oh my
timing.
God, perfect timing!
Woo!
That was awesome on a stick. Pose.
Oh.
And we're back.
And we're starting.
And we're starting. Okay. Perfect. This segment thing is like really working
out. It's kind
of fun. Oh my God, it's really working out.
So,
okay,
yeah.
So it's time for Showgirls.
Give me my feathers, baby.
Feather bows. Because we are showgirls. Because we are showgirls.
We're going to show a tail.
You know what we need? We need, oh my God, now mine smells like maple syrup.
Still does.
Yours has infected mine with maple syrup.
We got maple syrup, baby. Well, hello, legendary crafting icon husband.
Hi, Adam.
Hi, Adam.
Hi.
How's it going?
Time for a sippy.
Oh, okay.
Is it? Alrighty.
Sippy.
Oh my god. Amazing.
That was fantastic.
That was the best thing ever.
That was our first guest sipper.
I know.
High five.
You got feathers on your face.
Get them off.
I got it.
Thank you.
You're welcome. All right, Showgirls.
Okay, time for Showgirls.
You have more, so.
Oh, I only get, well, only one in progress.
Oh, okay, never mind. We both have the same.
Yeah. So, I think we both have a theme going here because we're both working on socks. So, on the needles today, Simple Vanilla Fish Lips Kiss Heel Sock. I use the heel, and then for the regular sock, I just use my standard toe-up sock recipe. But this is
delicious.
Desert Vista Dye Works. I don't know if it's going to focus.
It probably is.
Probably not. But if it
that's
does.
That's in Peter Max, right?
And this is the Peter Max colorway.
Isn't that fabulous?
Sock number one.
I love it.
Isn't it gorgeous?
It's a little too small for my foot, though.
Well, yeah. There's a reason for that. It's not for your foot. But, okay. Showgirl.
Oh, I have two things. No, I don't. I have one thing.
That's, because I think that was all I didn't bring any other works in progress.
I didn't. I don't have anything. Yeah, this. I'm working on the second sock of the basic cable sock.
Yeah.
And I'm about to start decreasing my toe, because I'm really trying to get some stuff done for Whippapalooza Extravaganza-thon.
Yes, because it is now the second month.
So
we are doing Whippapalooza Extravaganza-thon for finishing all those whips that we cast on during June was cast on a palooza.
Because we took a break, right?
We took July off, and then August and September.
Because of your job thing.
Yeah, Whippapalooza Extravaganza-thon, which is finishing up all the stuff we cast on in June for cast on a palooza. So,
if you guys have the Whippapalooza Extravaganza-thons to finish items, go ahead and hashtag it, and we will find you.
Hashtag it on Instagram. Yeah. Whippapalooza Extravaganza-thon. Or join our Ravelry group if you have not done so already. We would love to see you there.
We have cookies.
Yes. It's called Come Knit With Us. Go find us.
That's right. We have cookies.
We do.
Yeah, this is really hot again.
It is really hot again.
It smells very breakfasty.
It does smell very breakfasty, but it feels very sexy showgirl.
It does. I'm going to make us headdresses.
I think you should find better boas. You said you had better boas.
I was looking for my boas, and apparently I don't have my boas anymore. I have wigs. But I am going to create some headdresses that are easily slipped on and off.
What are they
going to
do with my bangs?
Nothing at all.
Are you sure?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So are we done with Showgirls?
I believe we're done with Showgirls.
Okay.
Showgirls.
Yep.
Showgirls.
Showgirls.
Showgirls. I'm not a weirdo. You love me.
I do. I do love it. Okay, so Feather
Duster.
Mission. Okay.
What was her name in the Beauty and the Beast, the Feather Duster?
Oh my god.
The actress who played it on the musical was Paige from...
I have no idea. Oh my god, look.
Ooh, that's some...
Mm. I had a little feather. Mm. Getting fresh. Got to second base. Mm. Poor got to second base. Okay, so, next segment...
Wait, do you want to say hi to Dan real quick? Can you do the Pam gesture first?
Oh my god, here's Liz.
Here comes Liz!
Whose total fault this is.
She's the one who decided that we had to do this.
Uh-huh.
And Candace came up
right.
with the idea of what to do.
That's right. Our hand gesture.
Say hi.
Say hi, Liz.
Hi.
Save the Dan.
Save the Dan. Dan. There we go. Thank you, dear.
Bye, love.
Bye.
It's her fault she had to be included.
That's right. She was all proud
is that
of it.
Kristen?
Yes. It is.
Gherkin's Bucket
Thank
doing
you,
ballet.
Gherkin's Bucket. Thank you. Is she on her ballet bar?
She was doing ballet. She did an etu.
Oh, awesome. Okay. Oh. So are we ready now for the next segment?
Yes, I think we is.
Okay.
Oh, I'm dropping things.
Okay, the next segment is...
These are stethoscopes.
Okay. I have searched high and low...
Oh, I guess I'd have to pull this.
Can you hear
Nothing
me?
Is empty.
Yeah, that's right. There's a black cavernous
Put one up here.
Hole.
Put one up here.
Black cavernous hole. Wait a minute.
Anything? Anything? Squirrel!
I think I heard some sort of 80s dance music.
Probably.
I'm not sure which one though.
Okay.
I couldn't make it out.
Okay, so the prop.
This is supposed to be.
It's alive!
It's alive! For Dr. Frankenstein, but I have looked high and low all over this Dagum Valley for a Frankenstein face and have not.
I will try to talk to my hubby.
Halloween store didn't even have one.
I'll talk to my husband.
Didn't even have one. So there should be like a
this is for the FOs.
Here.
This is for FOs.
Yeah, it's alive because it's dead. Okay. So you have many.
I have three.
So you go first, and I only have one.
I finished it. This is the gorgeous wingspan out of the hand-spun yarn from legendary crafting icon Kathy Canuel.
It's beautiful.
And it's washed and blocked, and I love it.
And it's gorgeous, and
you
can't
have one,
wait
right?
for it to... Yeah, I just have one.
Well, and I have one that goes along with it because I had enough yarn left over that I made hair bows in three different sizes with dog hair. Aren't they cute? I'm going to get some clips, and then I'm going to make them really cute in my hair because I just couldn't waste a drop of the yarn.
No, that's beautiful. That's out of
Aren't
the same.
Aren't they cute?
Yes.
Yeah. It's a garter stitch one. This is my own pattern, of course. Seed stitch one.
Yeah.
And a multiple stitched one.
I think that's so cute.
Isn't that
cute? The seed stitch is my favorite, obviously.
Yeah. And that one, of course, took the longest. But I just, you know, I love hair bows.
You do. You're a fascinator kind of girl.
I am.
You are.
Go ahead. Your turn.
Well, how many do you have left?
One.
Oh, okay. So my finished object is what I was actually working on last week, and if you follow me on Instagram
at Kimmy Knits
or have seen these on Ravelry, because I spammed the crap.
You did. I went and looked at what you had just posted.
Yeah.
Suck, 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 suck.
I spammed the crap out of these. So they are my Mind the Gap knee socks.
Aren't they lovely? Just like she is.
Aren't they cute?
Just as cute.
And
as you
it are. Was Mind the Gap. I don't know if this is gonna focus. I'm really sorry if it doesn't. It's Mind the Gap by Trailing Clouds. It's BFL and nylon. It was a total of, it says 464 yards. It was 100 grams. What I did was I weighed it out on my scale and it came to 3.5 grams.
Uh-huh.
And so I split it in half exactly, mm-hmm. 1.75 grams each ball. And then I started toe up and knit until it was done. And I got two just over the knees. And I used the Fish Lips Kiss Heel, which I love. And there are pictures of them on our Ravelry group in the Whippapalooza Extravaganza-thon thread. And I've also posted them
in a various bunch of places.
I did. I posted them,
Instagram.
I think, to... Well, yeah, I've posted them on Instagram. I posted them to the Bakery Bears group in mm-hmm. Finished Stuff, What's Off Your Needles. And I think I posted it in Finished... Did I put it in Finished Things on the Wolf Farms?
I don't remember.
I can't remember. I posted
them
at least
three
places.
I think you might have, because...
Yeah.
Yes, you did, because Don says, I can't stop looking at these.
Oh, that's right, yeah, because I posted it in at least three places. I... I'm in love.
Stripey, stripey, stripey.
And it is the fall of stripes.
It is. I'm waiting for mine.
Yours will be knit by you. It'll be wonderful.
No, I'm waiting for my stripey sock yarn to arrive.
Oh, for your yarn to arrive.
I was not talking selfishly this time.
Oh my god. That's my bad.
That's right. Oh!
Oh! Perfect timing. We'll end on a low note for me.
I have one more thing to show, but I'll.
You have one more?
Yeah.
Well, keep it on.
No,
pose with it.
Go! Oh, okay.
Pose with it.
Because it's blocked and stuck.
And then we'll come back and we'll do, you'll talk about
okay.
it. Okay. Yep. There you go.
I am including this in the Whippa Palooza. Say it.
Use your words. Whippa Palooza Extravaganza.
I think I just swallowed my tongue.
Yeah.
It's all right. This was hand spun, hand dyed cotton that I bought 5 years ago. Cast on 5 years ago that I finally finished for the Whippapalooza Extravaganza.
That was back when we first met.
Yes, and this is described by Will as fairy fart yarn.
Yeah, well.
And it's cotton, so it wrecked
no
my
taste.
Hands. And it's the Lacey Bactus. I believe Blake is knitting. Hi, Blake! Knitting one right now.
Yeah.
And I finally got it finished, finally got it blocked, finally got the ends woven in, and I'm trying to figure out who to give it to.
That's very exciting. It's beautiful. Well, that was a lovely segment. I
Thank
enjoyed
you.
That very much.
Thank you.
Very much.
Thanks.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank y'all. Okay, so we're in part three.
Yeah.
We've done our two segments.
Hoarder's Corner, right?
Hoarder's Corner is next.
Yes. You go first.
So,
you have two things, so.
Welcome.
Hi.
to Hoarder's Corner.
That's right.
Where we talk stash and
just imagine a picture of Kim buried in her room of shame.
I'm still not sure what to do for Hoarder's Corner. It's a work in progress. We got to figure it out. There's got to be some sort of prop or picture or something that we can use for Hoarder's Corner. But it will not be me in my room of shame.
Sorry. Just imagine it.
Sorry, not sorry. Yeah, just use your imagination, people.
Labrador or feather?
Feathers. I've got feather dust on me. So probably that fairy stuff.
Yeah, it could be, yeah.
Fairy farts, I'm a lloyd. Okay, so stash enhancement. I got, I've enhanced quite a bit. I've enhanced. I'm waiting for some orders. But in the meantime, because I am nothing if not obsessive and compulsive and instant gratification, Kimmy, big time. So I
Something
went.
I love about her though.
I went on a field trip Thursday after work because I'm in that part of town. I went to the store that shall not be named. Jessica Knits. And I picked up two more skeins of Desert Vista Dye Works. So the first one I would like to show you is Witchy Woman.
Perfectly named.
Witchy Woman. It is self-striping. It has beautiful blood red, some black, some purple. It is.
And maroon.
Stun balls.
It's got two tones of red.
Yeah.
The red's like a very, really awesome variegated red.
Isn't it gorgeous?
That's going to look amazing.
Yeah.
It has 462 yards in it. That's a big chunk of yarn.
Yeah, that's what this one is too.
I know, that's still a big chunk of yarn.
So, probably socks. Probably socks.
Another pair of stripies?
Because this is, again, the fall of stripy socks for me.
I'm excited. Yeah. Of course, I'm waiting for my stripes to show up, but.
Your stripes will show up. They will come. They will come.
Okay, I will build yours. By chance, I wasn't going to have any stash enhancement this week because I did not purchase anything that has showed up at my doorstep yet. But Miss Kath Canuel, legendary crafting icon, brought me in a box of Angora Bunny.
Yeah.
Fiber. Ooh. Yeah. I've never worked with Angora for spinning. I wanted to keep it around my face for a while to see if I would have an allergic reaction. But this happens to be from another friend, Heather and Lori. They used to have bunnies and they raised them and she hand plucked them and processed the fiber. And
she spun some of that she spun it 100% Angora and the yarn itself was absolutely amazing. It looked like something that angels would want to knit with. Just beautiful. Speaking of angels. Did I get it?
Yes.
Oh my God, thank goodness.
And she did not kill my hand.
And I didn't kill you. No, I didn't. I pulled back.
You did, you did.
I pulled back.
The Hulk strength.
I did, I pulled back.
That Hulk strength.
So I didn't harm you. Because I love you.
No. I love you too.
Okay.
Don't touch your bangs.
No, don't. You know better than that. Just touch my bangs.
I'm touching my
okay,
bangs.
Okay, so is it time for my last one?
Yeah.
Okay, so my second and last stash enhancement of the week is yet another, yes, Desert Vista Dye Works. This one is called Free to Be.
Free to be you and me.
Free to be.
God, that's mine.
Oh my God, I know. Free to be. So cute. It's got beautiful psychedelic acidity Hanna-Barbera 70s children's
that
show.
That is a Hanna-Barbera. Yeah.
It reminds me of very much.
Yes.
H.R. Puffin style.
Yes, Witchy Poo.
So Free to Be, which was the show that it was inspired by. Very colorful like this too. So pretty. So yeah, I think this might be striped socks for me.
You should try one of the stripes do this thing.
I've seen those socks and I may eventually because I am not ashamed to admit that I have much more Desert Vista Dye Works on its way to me right now because I placed more than one order. Yes, I did. I'm a little embarrassed. I'm a little ashamed.
I'm sure she really appreciates.
Self-denial is just not my strong thing. I'm not good at it.
Why should you suffer? You shouldn't suffer.
I'm not good at it.
There's no way you
so
should suffer.
So not good at it.
No.
So I saw stuff I wanted and I,
Well, I'm not sure when my Desert Vista Dye Works order is going to come because of this big sale she's having.
Yeah.
It's 2 to 3 weeks probably. Yeah.
That's what I'm assuming, but that's okay because I've got stuff to keep me busy till then. And TYF was kind enough to find me another single skein of the Natural Cascade 220 that I'm using to border my blanket.
Did they really?
And
they rock. Tempe yarn and fiber rocks.
And science.
And beauty.
And beauty.
Yeah. Speaking of how gorgeous she is.
Oh, whatever.
You're gorgeous.
You're gorgeous.
I just started spitzing. It just got me.
It
just
got really me. Hot right all of a sudden.
Just, it did, didn't it? Just spitzed.
It got really warm.
You look really good there. We had delicious Italian food today.
Squirrel.
You know,
yeah, every time you do that, he's going to just like sneak up from the bottom.
Like, what was the gopher?
Squirrel!
The gopher photo.
That was a squirrel. That was where squirrel came from. It was that photo bombing squirrel.
I think the first time I saw that was when Alita used it on her avatar.
Yeah. I had it on mine for a long time.
I know.
It was so cute. I love that. But yeah, it always makes me think of Up.
Yes.
Because I love dog.
I love you. I just met you, but I love you.
But I love you. You are my master now.
That's like your cat, Spencer.
Oh, God.
I love you, Chair.
I love you, Chair.
I love you, Lamb. Table leg. I love you, Sam.
Yeah. Squirrel.
Mm-hmm. That is the cutest squirrel ever.
It is. It's a very sweet squirrel.
It's a nice gray squirrel. Where are gray squirrels from?
I don't know.
Find out. We must be science.
Google it.
Okay. Them be fighting words. Really?
Yeah, no.
You
I'm
bent
not.
There?
I,
you yeah. bent there? You know, even
I
though
did,
your
because
chair
it was
doesn't have wheels on it.
It was a shared joke.
You will be out of the shot in a second.
It was a shared joke because she was here.
That's true.
Yeah, a couple weeks ago she was here.
And I was not.
And this is an inside joke. No, it's not even a joke. It's a shared tragic experience, I think. Just a heinous, horrifying experience. But we don't talk smack, so, but yeah, we do. So yeah,
what's your favorite saying? You can't say
if
something nice.
If you don't have something nice to say, come sit next to me. Hmm? That's right. No, it was just some person that we didn't
mesh well with.
Yeah, we just didn't play well with others, really. And when we were having a discussion about something,
I wanted an answer.
Said, have you ever heard of Google? So from that day forward, this person became known as Google. And so every time we see this person, we're like, oh my God, there's Google. And yeah, that's what I say when I want to make her mad, is just Google it. And she goes, red rage.
Red rage!
Hulk smash!
Secret is I'm always angry.
That's right. That is my secret.
Secret.
Oh my God, I'm always hot, I think. I'm just sippy. I'm dying.
Okay.
I'm dying here. Okay. Oh my God, that's brutal.
Whew, okay. I was like, what's wrong with my phone? It's working.
That's
perfect timing.
Oh my God, we are doing so great on the time. Ah! Segments are magic.
I haven't dropped anything.
Segments are magic. Yeah, we've had no needles down.
No, nothing.
Okay, pause it.
Oh, okay.
Sorry about it.
She's sorry. Back there behind the
I
camera.
I was back there going. Because yeah, I'm a little warm.
Just hey,
little warm.
Did you
and
see
I'm
my
shedding.
Nail polish lip combo today?
I did. Of course I did. I saw it earlier when you showed it to me.
I just wanted, I'm getting ready for fall.
Yeah, fall. Oh, you're funny. You funny, baby.
I'm funny.
Funny.
Funny looking. Hey, let's say hi to some friends.
Let's say hi to lots of friends. So we always have to start with Dan and Kay.
Hi, Dan. Hi, Kay.
Because we have to, you know, save the Dan.
Save the Dan.
Save the Dan.
And I noticed that he thought that the Lego challenge was good.
Did he?
I Instagrammed a photograph of like a Lego walk of fire.
Bring it. Bring it.
I think one singular Lego would hurt more than a bunch, though.
Bring it. I've been walking on Legos since my son was 2. Good.
They were Duplos then, right? Because you didn't give him Legos. Those are the size of a button.
No, I gave him Legos when he was about... Oh, he probably had Legos when he was about 3.
Okay.
And it always with close adult supervision. Always. So, yes. I did not give him anything
Dan
that you could choke on.
Hi, Dan.
Hi to James and Dawn.
Hi, James. Hi, Dawn. Hi, Fuji. Dundee is getting so big.
It's enormous. That dog is huge.
Huge.
And then we would have to say hi to Nick Nacaroni.
Nick Nacaroni. Nick Nacaroni.
And hi to Helen.
Hi, Helen.
Hi to Blake. Hi to Jonathan.
Hi, Jonathan.
Hi to Navi. Sorry you're hung today. Sorry about it. I saw your Instagram earlier today when we were at lunch that you were hung over. And yeah, well, bummer, dude. Sorry about it.
It's his birthday month still? No, it's not his birthday month still.
No. My friend Kevin's birthday is next week, and I said, well, hallelujah, because finally you're going to be old like me. Because he has been months younger than me this whole time. He has been younger
That's
than
true.
Me ever since I turned the dreaded 48.
And then, hi, Laura.
Hi to Laura. Hi to Kate.
Hi, Kate. Ollie.
Hi, Ollie.
Ollie sent me a message this week on Ravelry with the cutest little frog pattern in it. It was so cute.
That's so cute.
I think I have that one in my favorite somewhere. So.
Probably. That's adorable.
Yeah.
I don't think I got emails from her this week. But work was
You've been busy.
Yeah, well. And it was a short work week because I only worked Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. But
yeah.
It was a long work week because I had to go in the office both Thursday and Friday, which is horrible. Let me see. So what else?
I just started watching. Is it James? The nerdy.
The dancer, dancing.
Dancing geek. Yeah.
He's cute, huh?
Yeah.
You're cute.
Cute.
And speaking of cute, hey Ron.
Oh my God! I went and stalked his page a little bit, and because he mentioned that there's a. He used to model the knits, and he had this pom-pom.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
The pom-pom scarf
was
really cute.
He's so pretty.
Very pretty.
So
Did
pretty.
You see the picture from last night on Instagram of he and Harrison?
Yeah.
So cute. I love you guys.
Mm-hmm.
So who else? And hey, Sarah. Lime Juicy.
Hi.
Don't know if she's even watching.
Molly.
What's
her name? Molly Malley.
Molly Malley? Molly O'Malley? Or?
Yeah. Hi.
Hey. Hi, Sue.
Hi, Sue.
How's it going?
And then, what about Claudino?
Oh, God. No, Knit Sherlock. Oh, my God. This is Claudino.
I bought five more of your patterns.
Yeah, and I got Patch because I had to. And I've been shopping for Yarn Honey, and I can't find anything that I like because I want mine to look just like yours because I'm a copycat that way. That bright, vivid orange that's like the orange in this, but I need that deep, dark blue that his
that
body's
midnight,
in. Yeah.
Midnight blue.
And you know what I have is I think I have I have a dark navy blue, but it's not, I have your Rios, but I wouldn't use that. But I have,
stop it, just don't.
I forgot.
You shouldn't have mentioned it. You could have used it.
You could wear the hat anyway. Oh, I wouldn't do that to you.
And
you
I would have been like, I bought you that to make me a hat?
Hello. Yes. But I think I have some that's either a monos, but it's a single, and I don't. So maybe it's, it could be a Malabrigo worsted, but I think it's monos and it's a dark blue, and that might work, but then I still need an orange, and I need a green. And I'm not 100% sure. Maybe I'll get that orange monos.
I think so.
I think I should.
Yeah, and then
Patch
you could,
so
then you could use that blue I picked up. And then, Omi.
No, I'm saying I have a different blue. A dark blue that might work. It's just not as perfect as
Patch is really cute. I need to invest in some better felt to sew on some of the details.
Because
I love how she sews the felt on.
Oh my gosh. The eyes are so cute with the felt behind them. But I love the little yellow moon. On his chest, it's so cute. But I need some fabric glue to stick that on too.
Yeah, I went on a shopping spree. I went and bought yarn and patterns. And
did you?
Mm-hmm.
I went on a little bit of a spree myself.
Yep,
I did.
I did buy makeup too.
I did not.
I bought some makeup geek.
I did not.
More makeup geek.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
I didn't because, oh my God, I have so much. But I thought it was so funny because I was on my way home from work on Friday. I stopped and I was looking for props for the show. And I was over in this little shopping plaza where there happens to be an Ulta. And I was thinking, oh, well, I'll just stop at Target and I'll stop at Toys R Us and then I'll go to Ulta. And then I was like, oh my God, I'm seriously sitting here thinking, oh, I'll just pop at Ulta. Like I could do that, number one, without spending hundreds of dollars. And number two, like, why? There is nothing that I need or want at this moment.
There's nothing you want?
No. I'm still waiting for Lorac to come out with their big palette and then. But until then, no, there's not. There's really not.
There's always something I want.
I know.
In the makeup world.
I know. Well, you know what? It's because I haven't.
Rocky Horror, MAC.
The Rocky Horror Mac, yeah. But I haven't gotten an Ulta Flyer in a while, and
I don't know
if it's
because... I just got mine, and they have so many new things in it.
Do they? Oh, man.
They have the new Urban Decay palette. They have a new Too Faced palette. Oh, my gosh. You're going to go, like, do I need this? I don't know if I'm going to get any of them, but I'm sure I probably will.
I'm sticking with yarn.
That's fine.
For right now. I'm sticking with yarn. And I'm still waiting for my order of the 220 Natural. And I just have to say once again, thank you to everyone who has sent me private messages on Ravelry and on Instagram letting me know where you have found the Natural. And if it doesn't come in soon,
you're going to take them up on it.
I probably will. Well, the thing is that I ordered it here. So yeah. I have to buy it here when it comes in, whether I get it somewhere else or not, because I already ordered it here. So,
are you saying that you won't be using that color again ever? That's like your
favorite
color.
No. I'm not saying that. That's why if it doesn't come soon and I really want to finish the blanket before winter, because there's only like 3 days where I'll get to use it, and yeah. I don't want to miss my opportunity. So
no, but you use that color so often.
I know, I do. I love natural. I love to use that as a border and an accent.
Cream.
And I do love the color cream. Speaking of, I needed to get some cream fingering weight to make that stripe study shawl with the new. What's the matter?
I was tangling up again.
It's a single. I know, it's why I hate knitting with a single. I'm sorry. Oh, don't cry. Like you would. Whatever.
Not over yarn.
Whoa. I need to get
good and ragey, throw it away rage.
Oh, been there. Been there. I had yarn that I swear, it was back, and Ollie remembers this yarn. I know you remember it. Because it was back when I first was going, we were going to this place called Cotton Fields,
uh-huh.
And I was knitting with Ollie, and there was this yarn that I bought, and I loved it, and it was a Jaeger or a Rowan. It was a Jaeger or a Rowan, and it was a cotton yarn. It was a beautiful color. I bought like 10 balls or 12 balls of it because I wanted to make a sweater. I was convinced that yarn had declared a jihad on me. Because no matter what I did with it, didn't turn out. I had to frog it. And I don't know where it is hiding out in my house, but I think it's probably
a bonfire.
Set up a training camp to train other yarns in the jihadis. I bet you. In my room of shame, which is why we won't go in there, because it's a scary place. Thanks for stopping by this week, you guys. We'll see you again next week.
She was feeling me up.
I was. I did. I got a feel. Second base, like the feather.
Hey.
We'll see you guys
Bye.
Next week. Bye.